that's one thing that will help the stable homeowner who's, you're right, meeting your payments and doing, you know, playing by the rules, and lucky you, lucky me that we don't have those worries, but if the banks get and use the funding the way it's intended, then I would hope that you'd be able to refinance your home. I can't promise it because it will depend on what the pressures are on the people who are losing their homes, with, you know, in the home. So, and then your other question was about, I believe, the postal service. One thing I know. Pardon me?
I think we just received data and a project today about the dire situation of our organization and how
Well, that's not, maybe that is a federal concern. I don't have anything in the recovery package that addresses Postal Service, but I know there's legislation and there's talk about the possibility of mail delivery being one day less than a week, because so much mail now goes electronically. And so I'll be watching that, and I'll be working with my local folks to see what is the best way to handle all of that. So thank you for calling me. Welcome. Bye now. So now we have the results of the salary cap poll. 89% of you wonderful listeners, 89% of you are for capping the CEO salaries. 7% of you are against it, and 4% are undecided. So thank you very much. We have a call for you from Karen from Guerneville, and she has a question about health care for seniors. Hi, Karen.
Hi, Lynn. How are you?
I'm fine. Yourself?
I'm not too bad. Thank you for calling me. I was having dinner, the phone rang, and all of a sudden I'm here on a town meeting. How exciting is that?
Oh, this is so much fun.
I know. Listen, I have a serious question about health care, and I'm going to give you some real-life examples of that, and there are two of them, one of which is a family member who lost her job, unemployment, 62 years old, cannot get health insurance, cannot afford it, even if she could get it, yet cannot pay for her prescription medication. She has no money. She's tried all the funding programs, including the ones of the local funding programs in which they want to charge her something like $700 a year to sign up to get a discount on medicines. And as a result, and she's not in good physical shape, as a result, she had to choose between meat and medicine. And that's not a choice I think that anybody in this country today should have to make. It's absurd. Secondly, if you're hit with a catastrophic illness and you are unable to work, even on disability, the cancer treatment costs for individuals in this country is enormous, and you could lose your home. And in fact, if family and friends had not stepped in, this person that I know very well would have been homeless, without insurance, without possible treatment. How is the stimulus program and how is the legislative body going to talk and address this immediate issue? And we're looking at actually leaving the state of California and trying to go someplace else where medical care is not so expensive.
Well, first of all, I'm going to tell you that I'm a single-payer proponent. If we had a single-payer system in this country, your friend would not be worried about that at all. So I can tell you that that's what we have to have, and how fast we're going to get there, has been increased by $87 billion over the next 2 years. So that's a big step, and that will be a big help for Medi-Cal in California.
So now she's unemployed, and because she's received unemployment payments, which are about to run out, she doesn't qualify for that. She's 62 and has no immediate benefits.
Well, what I would do, I mean, Medicaid, well, then the state, the county also has, it's being overburdened now because people are in your friend's same position. But,
she was laid off in the county, by the way. She was laid off in Santa Rosa County.
But I'm not talking about their health care plan, but they do have a plan for individuals who don't meet the needs of Medicaid or Medicare.
Right.
I think these funds will help them, but I don't know how they'll use them.
Yeah.
But, for laid off workers who had health care, the expense of COBRA is being offset by, I think, half. But, COBRA is so expensive anyway.
Yeah, I lost my job a couple years ago and I was on COBRA and it was $700 a month for COBRA insurance.
Right,
and I had dropped it.
$350 under this.
Right.
But I don't know how you can personally be on unemployment paying $350 a month for.
Yeah, she doesn't have anything at all right now. So we're all trying to jump in and help out. But it's just, we're all kind of looking at the same situation. She was a temp worker hired by the county for 1 year, and then she got laid off. And then there was a hiring freeze in the county, and subsequently she's one step away from sleeping in her car.
Well, that there's homelessness is created more often by health concerns and medical costs than any other reason. And that's why we have, as a nation, have to have moments there where every single person is covered. Now, this year, this is not how we grant. We have passed legislation that will ensure 4 million more children are covered on SCHIP. And that's that end of the spectrum. And what I keep saying is we need to have individuals your friend's age who have lost their job, they need to be covered by a program modeled after Medicare. I mean, we should just open up Medicare for people who have lost their jobs and don't qualify for Medicare yet.
I agree. I mean, if you get cancer in this country, you have to sell your home. You have to go into foreclosure. You can't have any assets before you qualify for programs. And even then, you're on a long waiting list. We were just lucky that we had family and friends who were able to jump in and assist in this situation. And this person is in remission. The family member is in remission. So literally,
get to my question.
We were months away from this now.
Yeah.
And now we're back okay.
Well, I wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Maybe the Medicaid part, the $87 billion over the next